Boy, when you hold it that long, it's almost as good as sex.
Hey, Drew, we're looking for you. Hey, man. Hey, I don't have time to talk now, but big party at my house later to celebrate my promotion.
No, wait.
I gotta talk to you now. Look, I just had a recovered memory, and you're the only one that can tell me if it's true.
Well, can it wait?
No, true. If the memory is true, my entire life is a lie.
Well, lie's better than what you got. Go with the lie.
Hey, Drew, come on now. We're all making sacrifices here. Lewis risked his job by being here, and I'm supposed to be parked behind the Walmart napping right now.
Well, all right, just hurry up.
Okay. Okay, we're little kids. We're in my basement, and we're playing Kerplunk. I've beaten you 4 out of 6 games. No, 5 out of 6 games. Okay, you won the first game.
Okay, yes, I remember. Oh, it was horrible, and yet we survived it. We must never speak of this again.
No. Anyway, my mother comes downstairs, and she calls me Aaron. Why Aaron? Okay, my thinking is that I used to have a twin. His name was Lewis, okay? Times are tough, they need the money, so they sell him to a barren Norwegian couple. Why? Tall, fair, and lanky, huh? Now, the rest of the story is just speculation. Now, to cover their tracks, they name me Lewis. And since I was 6, I was forced to live the life he would have lived instead of the life I should have lived, which was that of a dashing bodybuilding scientist. Now, Drew, you hold the key.
Your name's not Aaron, okay? It's Lewis. It never was. You never were a twin. It never happened.
Oh, okay, you're probably right. He's in on the cover-up. The government must have got to him.
So he's a robot, too.
We'll conduct tests when he's sleeping.
Right.
Bye.